Morning, 6th class students. In last our class, we already discussed about that vitamins and some nutrients and related to their diseases. It means if there is a deficiency, then the diseases. It means the deficiency diseases and what are the symptoms happen when the nutrients are lack in our body. So now this time we are discussing about how to maintain the food quality. How to maintain the food quality? It means we are taking the proper diet and proper amount of nutrients in our food or in our balanced diet, like vitamins, minerals, okay, protein, carbohydrates, fats. But sometimes if the way of taking of these nutrients are wrong, then we cannot fulfill the requirement of body by these nutrients. It means if we are taking balanced diet, but the way of taking of this balanced diet is not proper, then the amount of nutrients will not goes to inside our body, will be not proper. So how to maintain the food quality? How to maintain the food quality? Cooking of food means it should be cooked properly so that its nutrients are not lost. It means not too much time to take to cook the food and not the less time. It means the cooking time, it means cooking of food is the properly. Cooking food is the properly. So their nutrients will be kept or be will be remain in their food and so not lost. Advantage of cooking. What is the advantage of cooking? Food is cooked to make it is easy to digest, easy to eat. It means food is cooked because after that cooking, food is easy to eat and easy to digest and to kill the germs. So these three things are we need by the, and we can properly see that after the cooking the food, because after the cooked food is easy to eat, cooked food is easy to digest, and cooked food already killed the germs during the cooking time. So these three advantages we can get by the advantage of cooking, by the cooking. So now the disadvantage of cooking. I am writing here some points, okay, 5-6 points are there. These are showing that what is the disadvantage of cooking. Sometimes the cooking results in the loss of certain nutrients. It means very less amount of heating also just lost the certain amount of this useful nutrients. Like many useful proteins and minerals are lost if excess water is used during cooking and then thrown away. It means after the heating, some like proteins and minerals are generally lost during very less heating them. And if excess water used during cooking, we can thrown away, like that sometimes we are using for washing the rice or any pulses or like that. So these washed water, if we are just thrown away to outside, then many vitamins and many nutrients are just goes away. So we should see what is the right way. Only single wash. After that, we have to use this whole grains to prepare the food. So protein and mineral will not lost. Third one is vitamin C gets easily destroyed by heat during cooking. So vitamin C are generally easily destroyed during the heating. So also this is the disadvantage, because we cannot take the proper amount of vitamin C nutrients in our food if we cooked too much. Ascorbic acid is also a type of vitamin C. Folic acids, okay, vitamin B12 like, so vitamin B and B complex also, so which are susceptible to oxidation are readily by oxidized by brisk cooking. Brisk means fast cooking. It means if you are cooking too much fast, then this ascorbic acid and folic acid will be destroyed because they are susceptible to oxidation, are readily oxidized. So these easily they get oxidized and by brisk cooking. So due to the brisk cooking, we can destroy this two. It means ascorbic acid and folic acid. Now the minerals are also affected by high temperature. It means if we are giving too much high temperature to cook food, then it shows that that affected by the minerals, and minerals are just lost from that. In some cases, flavor may be lost by brisk cooking. It means if we are cooking too much fast, then their flavor also not good. You know about that, the full smell will come. It means burning smell will come from the oven. Food. So brisk cooking also not good, because the smell will not good, and if smell and flavor will not good of cooked food, then it is not easy to eat. Excessive cooking means too much cooking may also cause an adverse effect on the digestibility of the vegetable. Sometimes if we are too much cooking, maybe processed in this formation or the formation of cooked food, cooking food, then vegetables digestibility of also lost. So vegetables generally not digest when too much or excessive cooking can be happen. Okay, so I hope you understood this whole chapter. Okay, and we will discuss the question answer and exercise here, and in next video we will discuss about our third chapter. Okay, thank you.